Good morning, students. I hope you are all doing well at your home. Okay. So today in this session, we are going to learn about circles and different terms related to the circles. So finally, the time has come to close the loop from bubbles, bangles, rangolis, dosha. We make at our home. Car wheels to giant wheels. So many things that we see around us are circle in shape. So today we'll learn more about these shapes. There's no wonder if I say that circles rule our world, right? So we'll see the definition of circle. A circle is a set of all points in a plane which are at a fixed distance from a fixed point. I'll repeat, a circle is a set of all points in a plane which are at a fixed distance from a fixed point. So if I take a circle here, I told you that it's a set of all points in a plane which are at a fixed distance from a fixed point. The fixed point is called center of the circle, and the distance we are talking about is called radius of the circle. This is the fixed distance. From whatever the point you take, the radius will be same. R, from any point if you take, the radius is going to be the same. So look at the slide here. A circle is a set of all points in a plane which are at a fixed distance from a fixed point. See here, this is the center of the circle and this is the radius. Look at this video. What just happened? The radius is being rotated all over the circle, but the length of the radius is not going to change. Now we'll see about circumference of a circle. Here is a circle, and if I ask you to run around the boundary of the circle, you will run all this way, right? You'll start at this point and you'll run all this way and you'll end here. That is, you have completed one round. That is, you have ran the circumference of the circle. The distance you ran is called circumference of the circle. Next. See, this is the circumference of the circle. The distance, if you start from here and you are ending here, at the same point you'll start from the same point and you will end at the same point. Now again, I'll take a circle. And I'm taking any two random points on the circle. And I'll just join them with a line. So this line is a special line because it is being inserted in a circle. We name it as a chord. So I'll define you what is a chord. A chord is a line segment which joins any two points on the circumference of a circle. So if I take this line, this is also a chord. This is also a chord. This is also a chord. This and this. All these are chords because they are joining the two points on the circumference of a circle. Now again, I'm taking a circle. Since circle is a closed space, there has to be some limit for the longest chord that is possible in the circle. let us see what is the longest cord that we can insert in this circle. So I'll take a cord here. What I'll do is I'll push this up. What just happened? The length of the circle increased. I'll push this further up. This is the center of our circle. I'll push this again up. What just happened? Again the length increased. I push this up. Again the length increased. After further pushing up, what happened? The length decreased here. I'll push this up, up, up and up. What happened? It became smaller. So when I start from here, it started increasing till here. This is the longest cord that can be possible in a circle. The length is go on increasing, but after crossing this point, the length of the cord started decreasing. So this is the longest cord that can be inserted in a circle. So this is the longest cord. We have a name for it. It is called diameter of the circle. Diameter is the longest cord that can be inserted in a circle. If you can see, this particular diameter is passing around the center of the circle. So diameter has got properties to it. First property is that it is the longest cord. Second one is it passes through the center of the circle. Third one, as we already know that this distance from center to a point on the circumference of the circle is nothing but radius. Again, this distance also becomes radius because it is also starting from the center of the circle and ending at a point on the circumference of the circle. That is, diameter is nothing but r plus r. That is 2r. Diameter is twice the length of the radius. Okay, now look at this slide here. We'll quickly define the definitions of chord and diameter. See, here is a circle. AB is a chord here. AB is a line segment joining two points on the circumference of the circle. Here AB in the second circle, AB is the diameter. It is also joining the two points on the circumference of a circle, but the condition is that it is passing through the center of the circle. Now we'll see regions of a circle. Whatever is outside the circle is called the exterior part of the circle, exterior region of the circle. This whole region outside the circle is called the exterior region of the circle because it is outside the circle. And whatever is inside the circle is called interior region of the circle because it is inside the circle. And when we talk about the points which are lying on the circle are called circumference of the circle, that we just learnt now. This is the circumference of the circle. The yellow color line is the circumference of the circle. Next, we'll see position of a point with respect to a circle. See, here is a circle and there are many points over it. We will decide the positions of the point which are there in that circle. We'll classify them. See here, we'll have exterior points of the circle. We'll have points on the circumference of the circle. and will have interior points of the circle. So now look at this slide, we'll see which are the exterior points, which are the interior points, and which are the points which are there on the circumference of the circle. So here if you see, S is a point which is outside the circle, so it comes under exterior point. Z is another point which is outside the circle, so it is also an exterior point. And R is outside the circle, I'll write it here in the exterior points, and Y is outside the circle, so this is also an exterior point. Now what about the points which are there on the circle, we'll classify them too. T is a point which is on the circle, and Q is a point which is on the circle, P is another point, and B is another point which is on the circle. Now let us see what are the points that are inside the circle, that are interior points. We have X, we have P, we have A, and we have C. These are the interior points of the circle. So this is how we classify the position of a point with respect to a circle. Okay, let's see further. I'll take a circle again and I'll denote two random points on this circle. This particular region is a path of circumference of the circle. So it has got a name to it. It is called an arc. It is called an arc of the circle. But when you see it, BA is also a part of the circumference, right? It is like this, BA. It is also a part of the circumference, and by the definition I gave you, it also has to be an arc. Then what is the difference between these two? AB is like this. What is the difference between these two? They have got names to it. As it is smaller, I can call it as minor arc because this is small, and this is major arc because it is big. Now AB here is a chord. Let us see what happens if AB is a diameter of the same circle. It is a diameter which passes through the center of the circle. Now what about this arc and this arc? See, both arcs are same in length, we can say that, because diameter passes through exactly center of the circle, the length of this arc and the length of this arc will be same. Now we cannot name them as minor and major circles, so we'll name it as semicircular arcs. As these arcs are formed by the semicircle, we name them as semicircular arcs. Okay. Now let's dig deeper into this mysterious shape. Look at the chocolate cake. It is very tasty, right? It looks tasty. So we'll see. Suppose you are at a birthday party and you have to slice the birthday cake so that this cake can be distributed among these friends. How you will do it? You will cut it in this way. This is how we usually cut a cake, like this. Will you see? The cake has been cut in this way. Yes, this is how the cake has been cut. So if I take two points here, AB, this OA is nothing but the radius of the circle, and OB is also another radius of the circle. And this AB, if you observe, this is a minor arc. So this particular region has a name to it. It is called sector of a circle. So I'll just separate this piece of cake from the whole circle. What will be left? This shape. If I remove this piece, I'll get this shape. Now if you observe this shape, this is also bounded by the two radii and an arc. And by the definition I gave you, this also has to be a sector of a circle. This is also a sector of a circle. But the only difference is this one is smaller and this one is bigger. Now when we are talking about sectors of a circle, so that we don't get confused, we give them some obvious names. This is minor sector, as this is smaller, and this is major sector. Right? Next. Let's go back to the piece of cake again. What happened? This time the cake has been cut this way. They didn't cut it like this. They have cut it like this. We'll see it. We'll draw it. This is a circle and the cake has been cut like this. Right? This is obviously a badly cut piece of cake, because usually we don't cut cakes like this. Right? But this badly cut piece of cake has a name to it. It is called the segment of a circle. We'll see. I'll remove this part. AB. I'll define you. A segment is a region enclosed between chord of a circle and arc of a circle. This is the arc and this is the chord. And this region enclosed between the chord and arc of a circle is called segment of a circle. If I take another part, the rest of the part, this also is enclosed between chord and arc. So by the definition, this also has to be a segment. Same concept here. As this is small, we call it minor segment. As this is big, we call it as major segment. Now, look at this slide, children. We'll define what are sectors and segments. See here, the region enclosed between the two radii of the circle and the minor arc is called minor sector. And the region enclosed between two radii of the circle and the major arc is called the major sector. The region enclosed between chord and minor arc is minor segment. The region enclosed between chord and major arc is called major segment. Now, we have already seen how points and circles interact in a plane. Now we'll see how lines and circles interact in a plane. Of course, this board is a plane. We'll see how lines and circles interact in a plane. For this, I'll take a circle and I'll take a line. There are three cases in which this line can be placed on a plane. Case one is that the line is not touching the circle at all. Case 2, if I push this line little up, it will touch the circle at one point. In the case 3, if I push it further up, it will touch the circle at 2 points. See, in the first case, the line is not touching the circle at all, so there's no name for it. But in the second case, the line and the circle has some relation that they are touching at one point. So in this case, this line is called the tangent of a circle. In the third case, the line is cutting the circle at two different points. In this case, we'll call this line as the secant of a circle. This is the center of the circle. And wait, this somewhat looks like the chord of the circle. I told you that chord also is a line segment which connects two points on the circumference of the circle. This is somewhat looking same like a chord, but the only difference is the secant can be extended in both the ways, whereas you cannot extend the chord. Chord is just a line segment. And we know that line segment has n points and they cannot be extended. This is a line and which can be extended in both the ways. Now look at this slide. We'll define what is a tangent and a secant. A tangent is a line which touches a circle at only one point. This point is called the point of contact of the circle and tangent, because this is the point where both are touching each other. Okay, now let's see about the secant of the circle. Secant is a line which touches the circle at two different points. It not only touches the circle, it cuts the circle. See, here is A and B. A and B are the two different points. Now we'll see what are concentric circles. Concentric circles are the circles which have same center but different radius. There is no such condition that only two circles should be concentric. Two or more circles can also be concentric. Let's draw them and see. Concentric circles. I'll take a circle. This is the center of the circle. I'll draw another circle and one more. Here we have three circles which share the same center but they are of different radius. If I talk about the radius of the inner circle, this is, if I say it R1, and the radius of the middle circle is R2. Radius of the outer circle is R3. See, you can clearly differentiate that the radius of these three circles are different. This is small, this is big, and this is medium. So, but all these circles are sharing the same center. These are called concentric circles. Circles which have same center but different radii are called concentric circles. Now, quickly, we'll see what are congruent circles also. We all know about congruency, that objects which are having same shape and same size are said to be congruent. When I talk about circles, circles obviously have same shapes. But when coming to same size, if two circles, if we want them to be the same size, then their radius should be equal. Suppose if this is 5 cm. And this radius of the second circle is also 5 cm, then they are said to be congruent. So, in other words, I can say that if they have equal radii, then the circles are congruent. Circles are congruent, two circles are congruent if they have equal radii. So children, I hope you will learn the terms of the circles very well. Please remember them, because they are going to follow you again and again in geometry. They're very important. I hope you will remember them. Thank you.